We got Antonina Shevchenko back here on the program. She's going to be making her UFC debut on November 30th at the Ultimate Fighter Season 28 finale. Antonina, how are you today?
Thank you, James. Very great, feeling great, training going great, so feeling good.
That's great. Good to hear. First, let's talk about your win on the Contender Series. You get that impressive TKO victory. Did you feel like you had a UFC contract when you got the win, or were you a little bit worried? Because with Contender Series, you never really know if you'll get the contract or not.
I didn't have, I think, time to be worried or something. So before the fight, I was thinking about just victory. And of course, during the fight and before the fight, I was thinking about recent victory, just to get this TKO, KO or something, to finish the fight earlier. And when I did it, there was no time to think or something or to be worried. We just waited a few minutes and they called us and I knew that I had a QC contract. So there was no time to be worried, but there was time for the fight and after just the happiness of winning the fight and receiving the contract.
And of course, they tell you that you get this fight on this Ultimate Fighter Season 28 card. It seems like you had a lot of notice for this fight. Is that correct? Because I feel like I knew about this matchup months ago, even after Contender Series.
I think I knew that I will fight in November. It's about beginning of September, so it was okay.
Okay, that's good. And we know, obviously, now that you have a new opponent. You were supposed to fight Ashley Evans-Smith. Now you're fighting Ji Yeon Kim. Was there much change in your training camp for the new opponent?
Not too much changes because for my fight with Ashley Evans-Smith, I was preparing the same. Of course, enforcing my strong game and everything, because you know, like Ashley Evans-Smith, I didn't see her wrestle very much or go into the ground very much, but fighting me, she probably would go to the ground and something else. So I was preparing for this game, for wrestling game, for everything. I think it's the same like Valentina prepares in her fight to be ready to stand up game, to wrestling, to ground game, for everything, because you don't know what opponent will do, what they have preparing for you. And when we change from the new opponent for Korean girl, I know she's good striker. She has strong punching, strong boxing technique, yes. Me too. I think I have the same strong boxing game. We didn't really change too much. We just keep going.
Okay, that makes sense. Do you feel like history is going to be on your side in this fight? And what I mean by that is Valentina revealed to me that you've won both of your belts against South Korean fighters, and Kim also happens to be South Korean. Do you think that'll help at all in this fight? Because it seems like that's the winning formula.
Coincidence,
yes, but yeah.
Things happen, of course, but it won't help me because these things doesn't help.
No. It's still an interesting tidbit, though, I think.
So. Even it's like recent fight or fight in 2003, 2005, it was in the past. This is new opponent. I'm different fighter now, and I think it will be exciting fight.
I mentioned your sister, a little bit disappointed that you weren't on the same card as her. It would have been, I think, pretty neat to see both of you fight on a UFC card together.
Oh, we would like to fight in the same card together, of course. But I think in the future, yes, we will.
Well, that's I'm sure that will end up happening. So let's talk about training camp. Like your sister, I know you've been around everywhere. You've had the opportunity to train with Chris Cyborg. How was that experience getting to work with one of the best female fighters in the world?
Valentina did train with Cyborg. I was not there, so I was in Las Vegas preparing for this fight. So preparation was going good. So I started before Valentina's fight in Dallas, September 8th. So it was starting like right there. And then we had a few weeks in Texas, in Houston. Then we went to Las Vegas, and now we're here in Maine. It will be 3 weeks now that we are here. Very beautiful place. I like here the nature. Even a little bit before when we came here, the trees with yellow leaves and the nature is amazing, very beautiful. So, and the next week we already come back to Las Vegas to be ready for my fight because it will be like less than 2 weeks.
That's right. Who did you get to train with when you were in Las Vegas as far as training partners?
There was a different training partner who came to train with us in UFC Performance Institute. Local guys from different gyms that helped me and Valentina doing sparring, doing techniques, doing everything.
Okay, and anyone in particular, any UFC fighters that you got to work with?
Just Valentina.
Oh, just Valentina. Okay, fair enough. And then what about in Maine? Is it just the two of you training together, or do you have anyone else that you're working with?
No, of course not, because we need different sparring partners. We so long we train together with Valentina. We know each other, so we cannot...
You need to switch it up, yes. Yeah.
We have to do it. And we train here in local gym, Team Lawton Martial Arts. Very good friends, very good people there, and guys came from different towns near here to train with us, different sparring partners, and they actually, some of our sparring partners, they actually will fight this Saturday in Portland, so they also were preparing with us, different guys, different size, different opponents, strikers, grapplers, MMA fighters, complete fighters, so different.
How's the weight cut going? This fight, like you mentioned, is next weekend.
Yeah, weight cut is going well for me, because I prefer what I do, I prefer to cut my weight till this certain number early and to train in this weight and just to have a little sweat before the fight. I don't use this pressure to my body to cut in like too much night before the weigh-in or something like that. So I'm already near and just keep in this position before last days before the fight.
And I should mention that's 2 weeks. I got my dates mixed up, but you know what I mean. This fight's on the November 30th. Is there anything during training camp that you miss having that you can't eat right now that you really wish you could have?
Yes, of course. Different thing, because I'm comparing with Valentina, I'm on a strict diet.
Okay.
Because Valentina doesn't have any problems to cut weight because she's in this about 135 always. She's just okay with it, and I have a little bit of strict diet, but health food, salads and everything, so I miss sometimes the cheat meal. I don't know, the cakes. Mostly cakes.
Okay, fair enough. Are you going to be going to Valentina's fight the week after, a couple weeks after, in on the Toronto card?
Yeah.
Okay, I was going to say, because you usually don't miss your fights. Anytime I've seen Valentina fight, you're always there in her corner, which is great.
I'm trying, of course, because I try to support Valentina to help her in everything she needs before the fight. And, of course, definitely after my fight, I will go with all our team, Team Bullet, with our coach, Pavel Fedotov, with our manager. We are going to Canada.
Okay, that's great. And how do you see this fight playing out on the 30th?
I mean, we're planning, of course, different things and plan A, plan B, plan C, you never know, but we preparing for good performance, strong performance. That's why I'm training so hard now. So do my best. It's just what I can say.
Okay. And is there any cards you want to fight on next year? The UFC's released their schedules, or I know you're not looking past this fight, but I'm sure you want to keep active next year with your fights in the UFC.
I definitely want to fight more often. So if this fight will happen and will end without injuries or something, I would love to have recently fight. I mean, to fight just January or February to have more fights. It's just give you experience with every fight you get. You becoming stronger and stronger fighter.
Okay. And I'm sure you've thought of the obvious, which is, you know, if your sister wins the title, you know, you're new in the division, but the division is wide open at the moment. You have an undefeated record. I imagine if you get the win here, you get a few other wins, you're probably going to be talking about a title shot. What would you do in that situation? Would you move up a weight class? Would you move down? What? I know it's really far down the line, but I'm sure you've thought about it down the line.
We were really thinking that probably in the future there will be this situation, but we didn't think yet what we'll do.
Okay, fair enough. But just to be clear, you would not fight your sister, correct?
No, it's okay. Definitely I would not fight my sister because there are so many girls to fight with. And no, it's definitely not. It's not the sport, MMA, it's not the sport where sister can fight together.
Right. And you guys fight each other enough in training, right? With sparring and everything, right?
Yeah, but this is different.
Yes. No, it is different. Yes. No, I agree with that. I was talking to Valentina. I know that, you know, when it comes to downtime, you like going on hikes, you like going on walks, everything like that. Do you watch any television at all or not at all?
Very little, but some certain programs that we are interested in, online.
Okay. Well, what's a television show you like watching right now?
I mean, it's online on YouTube, some programs about, I don't know, about traveling, about...
Okay. Cooking. You like traveling shows. You like traveling the globe a bit, I bet.
Yeah.
Is there anywhere that you haven't traveled to that you'd like to travel to?
Yes, of course. We have not been to Australia, so I would like to Australia very much. And Africa, I think we have not been to Africa. And Alaska, of course, too.
Okay, that sounds good. And in the meantime, everyone's going to watch this fight. It's the Ultimate Fighter Season 28 finale on November 30th. Antonina, I always appreciate you taking the time. Just remind people where they can find you on social media. And if you have any sponsors or shout outs, the floor is yours.
People can find me in social media as Antonina Pantera. So follow me, please support me in the fight. It will be very, very nice.